So, thank you very much. Let me introduce myself first. I'm Brahan Wasto from Addis Ababa University. I'm a PhD student there. Of course, I am an instructor in one university in the province. Now I am appearing researching the first year in Deusto University. I am from Ethiopia. I think some of you may not know where Ethiopia is. So it is the part of the world based in the Horn of Africa. Ethiopia is a very traditional or a country that has traditional culture, history and the like. Yes, coffee. Coffee is the origin of coffee is Ethiopia. But I want to say something only about these things. Ethiopia is a country that has its own letters. These are the letters that we use in our country and the numbers also. Here we have the numbers, our own numbers. Most of the time we use these things to teach, especially at elementary level, the language of instruction media. But at secondary, and then we use most of the time English. Yes.
Yeah, I'm just saying that it's curious because in the rest of the world we use the so-called Arab numbers, and you being so close to the Arabs, you don't. So.
There are extreme difference from the Arabic. These are the Arabic numbers that we call. So these numbers are different from the Arabic numbers in one way. So we have our unique way of writing the numbers, the words, the letters. Even we have also our own calendar, which is different from the other. It starts on September. And this is just simply to say something about my country, my place. So let me come to my presentation. The topic of my dissertation is modularization in Ethiopian higher education institutions, theory and practice. This is the topic of my dissertation, PhD dissertation. But for the tuning practice, I will come to later on, especially on finding. I only emphasize on the first question of my research, but this is the total dissertation or the title of my PhD dissertation. So I want to start from the background part. You know, we have two philosophies for higher education when we talk about curriculum. The philosophy of education, sometimes we have an argument between these two philosophies. One, education for the sake of knowledge itself, or knowledge for the sake of knowledge. And the other one is knowledge for the sake of work, for the sake of societal problem. But there are some people who argue against this false dichotomy, considering this separation is not realistic, because you can't separate knowledge from practice. But especially during the liberal, during the medieval period, liberal education was a dominant education philosophy, which argues universities should teach intellectual aspect and should produce the ideal person. Especially, you know, the book written by Newman, The Idea of University. He argues that universities should teach the ideal person, a place for knowledge. So this is the dominant philosophy during the medieval period. But later on, during the modern period, because of the economic problem, the different aspects, emphasis has been started to be given for vocational education. This is when competence-based education becomes a dominant philosophy in the world arena. So these are some of the points related to competence-based education. When you say competence-based education, we are talking about these issues. It's emphasis for acquisition of skills rather than subject matter or theoretical knowledge. Requires better workplace relevance, putting those important issues that make the student relevant in the world of work. Focusing on measurable and observable competencies, adaptive to the student, to the society, to the teachers, even sometimes to the needs of the administration. It encourages integration between theory and practice, as opposed to the liberal education, which emphasizes on the theoretical aspect. The other one is recognition, it's recognition of individual difference. Its ability to address the individual difference and the use of variety of styles. Because of the different advantages, it starts to dominate the educational arena of the different parts of the world. Not only the philosophy of the education, but it also influences the way the curriculum was designed. So this is when it comes to modularization important in higher education institutions. Well, this term is not usual, common here, but in our country we use this term in many situations. It is just a kind of an approach used to put competence-based education into practice, especially to design the curriculum. It is a way of designing curriculum based on modules. When I come to the statement of the problem, you know, Ethiopia was a country which had a very serious problem, especially before 20, 30 years, because of war, civil war, and the like. So we have a very bad history during the past, especially after the 1990s, the government started to reform the country in general aspect. One aspect of that reform is higher education. So we have a lot of changes, especially in higher education. Previously, before 1990s, we have only one university in the country at that time. But now we have 34 universities. Look at the difference within 40 years. Even within the last 20 years, last 10 years, we opened 20 universities. So this is part of the total reform of the country, the economy. And even not only the number, the curriculum itself has also a problem during that time. Most of the time it is content oriented, subject matter knowledge or theoretical aspect rather than content or the curriculum that help the student to make competent in the world of market. So everything was considered as a very serious issue in the state. So it starts to reform. So new policies, proclamations, issues are issued and implemented, and we have also started to expand the number of the universities. We have still, there is also another plan to open additional universities, and even emphasis was also given for aligning the curriculum or the curriculum of higher education institutions with the needs of the country. So a number of measures have been taken. Especially after these policies were issued, the government obliged all higher education institutions to look at their curriculum in relation to the demand of the country. So they started to study or to develop a strategy. So they used the BPR. This BPR, I think you know, it's business process engineering. It is a business term, but they use in education. So they start to study the problems. One important point that the BPR emphasized was harmonization or modularizing the curriculum. Modularization was one aspect of the BPR, the proposal, the issues proposed by the BPR document, all conducted in all institutions. So, especially in 2013, all universities, especially almost all universities in our country are owned by the government, the state. Almost all. We have very few, two or three universities owned by the private. Otherwise, all universities are owned by the state, the government. So the government obliged all higher education institutions to modularize their curriculum, to have a harmonized curriculum, the same curriculum. So that curriculum came into being or into practice in 2012-2013. However, whether or not the modular approach, the philosophy, okay, in Ethiopia, higher education institution is properly conceptualized is another an important issue, an important question. So this is especially its clarity, advantage, steps followed to design the curriculum, its practicality, and implementation of modular approach becomes an issue of debate in Ethiopian higher education institutions. So this is the striking question. Does modularization properly conceptualized and practiced in Ethiopian higher education institutions? That motivated me to come to this study. There are also research gaps. Of course, the implementation is very new, but still we need to have some research. Some individuals have done research, especially on the view, the attitude of the instructors and students towards this modularization. Otherwise, the practice, the understanding. So this is my emphasis in my study. So it's very important to deal with the issue. These are the research questions that I formulated to answer to deal with my topic. I think the questions are many and even broad. The first question is, how is modularization conceptualized in Ethiopian higher education industry? The understanding of the stakeholders, the students, even the those individuals working in the Ministry of Education. The philosophy behind, okay? Why and how modularization is introduced into Ethiopia? Why? The rationale behind. How does the process of designing the curriculum look like? How do university students, teachers, and leaders are practicing modularization? And what are the major bottlenecks for proper implementation of modularization? But for the case of my later findings, I only emphasized on the first question. How is modularization conceptualized in Ethiopian higher education institutions? These are the methods of research. I use qualitative multiple case study. I'm going to select three universities from three generation. We have three generation universities. First generation is divided based on the history of their establishment. First generation, second generation, and third generation. I'm going to select one universities from these three and then analyze each case, then case by case analysis. So data sources are key informants, members of university governing bodies. These are university presidents, deans, directors, department heads, academic staffs, teachers, the students. And I'm going to also interview some officials from the Ministry of Education, and I will also use documents from the institutions as well as from the government. These are the three data collection instruments: documentation, interviews, and focus group discussion. The sampling method, three sampling techniques. The first one is purposive sampling technique. Especially, I use this purposive sampling technique to select the universities. The three universities. Second, I use snowball sampling techniques to select the key informants. There are key individuals who are considered as an important individuals to initiate the idea of modularization at national as well as at university level. So after finding one key informant, asking another to propose another person. In this way, I will try to find as much as many of the individuals who are very important. The other one is maximum variation sampling technique. These techniques will be used to select, or I have tried to use this to select the student, the instructors, even the departments after selecting the college, all these things. So these are the sampling techniques I used in this study. Meaning of analysis context, this is using or analyzing the data from interview and from focus group discussion, analyzing not paragraph by paragraph, not word by word, but describing or prescribing it for its meaning, just by according in giving by meaning. The other one is I use also, I have said before, this the analysis. First, I analyze cases independently, then later on I will have another chapter to analyze the cases together, case by case analysis. This is my conceptual framework for the study, the whole picture of my study. Here, this is, there are initiating factors, especially related to the question, why modularization? Why modularization in Ethiopia? And who initiated, who introduced? This is, okay, these are questions related to its practice and challenges. One important point is stakeholders' understanding, facilities in the institutions, laboratories, libraries, workshops, and the like, instructional materials, the classroom, the different electronical devices that we use, whether there is also organizational framework. Do universities have their own framework that supports the implementation of modular approach? I want to see all of this. And the modularization process, the way they design the curriculum, the teaching learning process, and the assessment techniques. This is the conceptual framework for my study. Let me come to the findings. As I said before, my findings, I am going to write an article here because I am visiting researcher here. I want to focus only on the first question. So these findings are the findings that are related to the first question only, the conceptualization part. So the title itself is Modularization in Ethiopian Higher Education Institutions, How Stakeholders Understand It. So I have these specific questions, and I only analyze data for one public institution or public university, not the three, because I have collected only data for one. That is Wolkite University. It is from the third generation. From the three, only the third generation. So these are the major questions related to the conceptualizations. What do you understand about the concept of modularization? What makes modularization different from the other approach? And what are the advantages of modularization? I thought that these things may tell about their understanding of the concept itself and the philosophy behind modularization. So these are my samples, college deans. I used three college deans. I interviewed them. Instructors, I used focus group discussion for instructors and for the students. So 14 instructors from the three colleges and 26 students from the three colleges, the same college. Deans are also from the same college. I used to have discussion with the teachers and the students by grouping them into three. One focus group discussion in one college with five teachers. This is the way I collect the data for this analysis. So the findings of this study were made based on the major pre-established themes, based on the question. I have the three questions. So based on that, I have tried to establish themes. So the first one is meaning. The second one is the features of modularization. And the third one is advantage. But there are emerging themes from the data, from the interview and focus group discussion that I made with the teachers and the students and the deans also. So this is, for instance, for the first question, what do you understand about the concept of modularization? This is the pre-specified, pre-established theme that I already identified from the question. So for these themes, from the discussion we made from with the teachers, with the deans, and with the students, I have tried to find these major themes. So some individuals consider modularization is an approach that designs courses based on competencies. It is an approach that uses or organizes courses according to their logical order, not sequential order. You may organize courses based on, for instance, one best example, a chemistry teacher told me, previously we have three chemistry courses, organic chemistry 1, organic chemistry 2, organic chemistry 3. This course was taught independently in three semesters. But nowadays, this course were organized in one module. Not only this course, but also another. We have supportive course previously. We call supportive course. For instance, mathematics for chemistry student in a reported course previously. So that course has to be brought here where it supports, where it strengthens the content itself. So in this way, courses are organized based on their logical order rather than putting them in sequence. So they understand what modularization is this way. The other one is clustering or grouping close related courses in module. This is use of module. Most of the time, even the policy document says modularization is organizing course based on modules. So this is also another important point that I found from the study. The other one is integrating knowledge, skill, and attitudes, the integration. Previously, sometimes we teach knowledge in one course and the skill part in another course, what we call it practice or practical. But now we need to integrate these skills. This is also another important aspect of modularization. Use of student-centered approach, instruction, use of continuous assessment and ECTS, European Credit Transfer System, and harmonization. These are the themes that I found, or the issues that I found from the meaning of modularization. Here, I want to see the difference between the different stakeholders on the understanding, especially on the side of the students. The students, they do not know the term modularization when I ask them. They do not know, but they know the practice. But when I ask them about modularization, they don't know. They're confused. But when I try to make them the way they are learning now, to introduce the issue in another way, students try to understand it and they define it in this way: clustering close related courses in module, use of student-centered instruction. These are the themes that I found before, but to make them who says what, to indicate who says what. So these are the definitions provided by the students. These are the definitions, especially the college deans have some important understanding or better or wider understanding, because most of the college deans were teachers at that time, and some of them were also department heads. They have the opportunity to participate in the modular process to get the training and the like. So they give me a good point, the teachers also the same. These are the yellow colors are the points that are repeatedly raised by the participants, research participants. So especially these two issues: use of modules, designing course based on modules, and use of student-centered instruction are the repeatedly raised issues when they tell us about the definition of the term. The second one is related to the features. Features means characteristics, things that makes modularization different from the other approach, especially the traditional approach. So here, clarity, that means everything is clear in modular approach. Especially, I have the opportunity to meet some professors who are teaching there in the university. Here, there is a flexibility for the teachers to do. But in our country, everything is pre-specified in the curriculum. What is the role of the teacher? What's the role of the students? Even the kind of assignment students are going to take, and the weight of that assignment, the time when students are going to submit the assignment, everything is written on the curriculum all over the country, not only in one institution, for the same course. So they consider this, makes things very clear. So students know what to do at what time, and the teacher also knows. The other one is clarity is related to the competencies. In the previous time, you use objectives. Sometimes objectives are not clear for the students and for the teachers also to accomplish the task. So but now things are very clear for the students, for the teachers. Focus on competency, self-contained modules, integration, active student involvement, use of ECTS, linkage. Linkage means linking theory and practice, and linking educational institutions with the world of work, especially with industries, with factories, companies, and the like, and use of variety of learning assessment and teaching techniques. These are also the same as I said before, the issues raised by the students and issues raised by the instructors and the college deans. The yellow ones are still the repeatedly raised issues by the all groups. The third one is the advantage. So they considered modularization as a good because of the following points. One is harmonization. We have a harmonized curriculum at national level. Every curriculum or every subject in each university is the same. Everything, the methods the teachers choose to teach, the assessment techniques, all these things. The other one is mobility. Now students have the opportunity to move from one university to other, to the other university because of this harmonization. Student participation, the opportunity given for the student to participate. Linkage also taken as a good advantage. It's gives an opportunity for the institutions to have link. The other one is its ability to produce competent graduates. And student freedom also. Student freedom, the freedom to choose different modules, to join the kind of program they want to study, even to leave sometimes. Of course, this is in principle. We are not practicing this. They told me this way. In principle, students have the opportunity to leave their course at some time and to come back another time in the approach. These are the major findings. I think there are also intersections in this case. Here I put the meaning, the features and the advantage from the answer of from the response of the research participants. Some responses are taken as an advantage, as a meaning, as well as a feature of curriculum, so modularization. Some also, some of the themes that we that I have tried to find in the study are related to the features as well as the meaning. Especially, let me see this one, the themes that are considered as a meaning, as well as a feature, as well as an advantage of competence-based education. For instance, I have three major themes here. Competence-based, for instance, for competency, it is emphasis given the emphasis given for competencies by the modular approach. So the first one is the definition. One interview says it is an approach that focuses on competencies. In this case, the other one important feature of modularization is its heavy reliance on the identification, specification, incorporation, and evaluation of competencies. So competencies are very important elements of modularization. So these are considered as the features, the characteristics that makes modularization different from the other approach. And this is also taken as an advantage. Modular approach is a good because it gives more emphasis for competencies rather than academic knowledge. That means theoretical knowledge. These are the issues that the stakeholders mention in this way. Similar to competency, I have also student participation. They mention student participation in the definition, in the feature, as well as in the advantage. It is an educational philosophy that emphasizes on student-led instruction. Instruction means pedagogy, the teaching way. We use this term in our country that way. It may not be common here. One major characteristic of current education, that means a modular approach, is it is stress given to student participation. We are expected to do many things to successfully accomplish our core. This is the response of one student from the focus group discussion. So student participation is also considered as an advantage here in this case. So these are the issues that we can see as a meaning, as a feature, and as an advantage from the identified themes. Similar to that, I have also features which are considered as, or issues or themes which are considered as meaning, as well as features. Features as well as advantage, and meaning as well as, no need to go to these all issues. For instance, this one, harmonization. Harmonization. They consider the harmonization as also the meaning. Modularization is the process of harmonizing the content, that means learning activities, teaching learning strategy, assessment techniques, time allotted to deliver the module or the course and so on of higher education curriculum. This is the definition. So because of its harmonization principle, modularization is benefiting the students, higher education institutions and the country at large by establishing a common benchmark for a uniform delivery of the curriculum in all higher education institutions. Especially, we have a very serious problem of instructors, uniformity of instructors. There are some instructors who have professors, PhD holders, and masters. But there are also institutions which uses first graduate, first degree graduates, instructors to teach first degree students because of the mushrooming of the universities. So, but having this harmonized curriculum is taken as an advantage to maintain the balance between, because they are using the same material, the same reference books, the content and the like. What makes difference is the experience of the professor. So they take this as an advantage, the harmonization, because of this problem. So these are the issues that I want to tell in this diagram. And when I come to the concluding remark, despite the fact that there is limitation on the side of the students, especially in knowing the proper meaning of the term modularization, it's possible to say that students, teachers, and instructors have a wider understanding of the term modularization, which are closely related to the ones that literatures reveal in different works of the individuals. These are the summaries that major issues raised on the conceptualization. Focus on competencies, logical order of learning activities, use of modules, integrating knowledge, skill and attitude, use of students' internal instruction, continuous. These are the major issues or the summary of the points that I considered as the research participants have good understanding toward this modularization. Thank you very much. I think this is my... okay. Thank you very much. We can discuss.